I've built an app to help you host and sell online courses that will cost you a lot less than using tools like Teachable, Thinkific, Podia, or Kajabi. I've built it using Glide, my favorite no-code mobile app building platform. This means you'll be able to fully customize it, change its look completely, and add or remove features to suit your specific needs, all without having to code anything or hire an expensive programmer, basically saving you thousands of dollars on development costs. So if you were looking for an affordable option to host and sell online courses, this is for you. For a limited time, viewers of this channel can get this app for a 50% discount at grumo.com/courseapp. The app works both on Android and Apple phones. It takes only a few seconds to install, and you'll be able to start uploading and selling your courses immediately. Now, let me show you how the app works and how easy it is to customize it to suit even your wildest dreams. Let's do it. App overview, student experience. Your students will be able to browse your courses as soon as they install your app. They can search for courses. They can filter courses by category. Once they click on a course, they'll be able to see all the details for the course. How long the course is, how many lessons it has, the overall star rating for the course, a description of the course, a list with all the lessons in the course, a section with testimonials, and also a section with other recommended courses. If the student decides to buy the course, they can click on the Buy button, which will take them to a secure checkout page powered by Stripe. There, they can enter their credit card credentials, buy the course, and get access to it as soon as the transaction is approved. You can enable discount coupons too. This is a great feature to incentivize purchases. Coupons can be limited in quantity and have a deadline to them. I'll cover all the details on how to upload your courses and create coupons in a bit. But first, let me show you what it's like to take a course as a student. As soon as a student buys one of your courses, they'll see an enrolled message, and they'll be able to click on the lessons and start taking the course. Students can mark the lessons as completed. Once they complete the last lesson, they'll be automatically taken to a page where they can rate the course and enter a testimonial. The testimonials will appear immediately in the course detail page, where you'll be able to approve them or delete them. Students can also add their own comments or questions at the bottom of each lesson. I'll also show you in a bit how you can customize all these features. All students have their own profile page where they can see how many students they have, how many courses they are taking, and if they're instructors, how many courses they're teaching. They also can see a list with both the courses they're taking and the courses they're teaching as instructors, if any. That takes care of how your students interact with your online school. Now, let me show you how you, as the owner of the app, can customize the content, look, and functionality of the app. App overview, admin experience. When you log in as an admin, you'll be able to see two new menu items, admin and users, under the top right menu. Users will show you a list of all the users in your online school. Under the name of each user, you'll have a quick view of their stats. When you click on any user, you'll see a more detailed view of the user profile, with their stats on top, their bio, a link to their website, and then a list with the courses they're taking and the ones they're teaching, if any. Because you're logged in as an administrator, you'll be able to edit the details of any user by clicking the pencil icon on the top right of the screen. From there, you can promote anyone to the admin level if you want help managing your app. When you're done making any changes, click Done. Let's check out the admin menu item. Here's where you can create new content, like new categories, courses, and lessons. You can also see a summary of all the stats in your online school: total users, total courses, total lessons, total number of sales, and total earnings. You also can see a list with the most recent transactions. If you click on See All, you'll see a searchable list with all the transactions in reverse chronological order. Click on any transaction to see its details. As an admin, you can also edit items from the main screens. If we go back to the main course tab, you can select any course and click on the pencil icon to edit the course details. And the same goes for any lesson. Click on the pencil icon to edit the lesson contents too. And that's what the admin experience looks like. Now let me show you how you can customize the look of the app. Customize app design. Changing the look and feel of your app is extremely simple. Just click on Settings and then on Appearance. You can pick from 6 different themes, 3 light and 3 dark, and change the accent color as well. The next thing you may want to do is go to App Info and change your app's icon, title, author, and app's description to match the details of your online school. That takes care of the overall design settings for the app. Next are tabs. Under tabs, you can see a list of all the available tabs on your app. By default, all tabs are made visible and appear at the bottom of your screen. You can move tabs to your side menu, which I've done in this case for the admin and users tab, which are only visible for admin users. You can decide who can see any component under features, visibility. In this case, I have a condition that says only users with level equal to admin can see these tabs. If you don't want your users to see a tab, you can drag it to the hidden tabs area. For instance, the categories tab is now hidden, but if you wanted your students to see it, you can simply drag it to the visible tabs area and it will appear as a menu item at the bottom of the screen. But to simplify navigation, you want to have as little buttons as possible. So I prefer not to show the categories, so I'll keep it as hidden. Now, on to the design of the actual app screens. For that, click on the layout button. Now you can navigate to any part of the app, and on the right-hand side, you'll see a menu with a list of all the components that make up each screen. You can click on any component and change its look or which column is pulling data from. If you mess up anything, just remember you can click on the undo button until things look normal again. Once you're happy with how your online school app looks, you can start uploading your courses. I'll show you how to do that next. Upload your data. All your data is stored in a single Google Sheet document, which is super easy to edit. Your app already comes populated with a bunch of dummy data, which you can simply delete and then start adding your own data. To access the Google Sheet for your app, click the pencil icon here. The first thing you should do is change the admin user. For that, just go to the users table and change the name and email for the admin user in the first row with your own credentials. Now, you'll be able to log in into the app as an admin and be able to add and edit content from the app itself. Just click on the avatar icon and then click on the new admin user you just created. As soon as you do that, you'll be able to access all the admin features, including the admin and users menu. To add new courses, click on the admin menu and click on add new course. Fill in all the details like description, price, etc. If instead of a static image as the course banner, you want to display a sales video, just enter the URL of the video and the video will override any banner image. If you want to offer a discount coupon, just enter the coupon code, the discount amount as a percentage, the quantity of coupons available, and the coupon's expiry date. The next step will be to add lessons to the course. For that, go back to the admin page and click on Add Lessons. There, you select the course you want to add lessons to and enter all your lesson details. The easiest and cheapest way to host your lessons is by using YouTube. If you upload your videos to YouTube, make sure to change your video's visibility to unlisted so no one can find your course videos when searching online. You can also host your videos on platforms like Wistia or Vimeo. They cost money, but they offer great features too. Once you've added your lesson content, just click Submit to add it to the course. You can also add new categories. Currently, I have 3 categories, but you can either edit them or add new ones. If you have many courses, categories will make it easier for your students to find the courses they want. Once you're done adding all your courses, it's time to go live. Publish your app. To publish your app and start making millions, why not? Just click on share. Enter a URL and boom, your app is now live. It's that simple. All your students need to do is click on your app link and that will take them to your app's homepage. If they're using an Android phone, they just need to click on the button that says add to home screen. On an iPhone, you tap on the share icon located at the bottom of the page, then tap the add to home screen button, then tap add button at the top right corner of the screen, and the app will show on your home screen just like any other app. Now your students can click on the new app icon to open it, browse your courses, and buy them right from the app. Okay, so that's all you need to get up and running with my online school app. To get this app, go to grumo.com/courseapp. For a limited time, viewers of this channel can get this app for a 50% discount. So hurry up. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Happy course selling. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.